Today, we are going to learn how to use planned SAT experiment in the Phoenix GUI to see if our SAT experiment is going to work. The purpose of Phoenix planned SAT experiment is to simulate a SAT experiment and to estimate the probability that you are going to be able to find the sites and solve your structure. Let's see how planned SAT experiment works. There are two key steps in solving a structure by SAT phasing. These are finding the substructure of anomalously scattering atoms and calculating a map that can be interpreted. The anomalous signal is going to determine your chances of finding the substructure, and the anomalous correlation is going to determine the quality of your map. The anomalous signal is the peak height in an anomalous difference Fourier, such as the yellow peaks in this picture. The anomalous signal is essentially the information per site in the anomalous differences. The substructure is likely to be found if the anomalous signal S is about 10 or greater. The anomalous correlation, CC star ANO, is the correlation of your anomalous differences with ideal ones for your structure. It represents the accuracy of your anomalous data, and it determines the accuracy of phasing, and therefore the quality of the map that you can obtain. The anomalous signal is the key to finding the substructure. Here are the things that are going to determine your anomalous signal S. S is proportional to the anomalous correlation. It is proportional to the square root of the ratio of the number of reflections to the number of sites. It is reduced if the anomalous substructure is not well ordered. We can plan a SAT experiment by simulating the anomalous signal that we would expect to obtain. The anomalous signal is going to depend on the I over sigma of the data, the accuracy of the data. It will depend on the anomalous atom based on the wavelength and scattering factor for this atom. It will depend on the number of sites and the resolution. It will depend indirectly on the sequence of your macromolecule, particularly at wavelengths longer than about 1.7 angstroms, because oxygen and other atoms in your structure will contribute to the anomalous scattering in a way that amounts to noise. Putting all these together, we can estimate the anomalous signal. Let's calculate the expected anomalous signal in a real data set. In the main Phoenix GUI, under Experimental Phasing, select Plan SAT Experiment. A new Plan SAT Experiment will open. Put in a job title to help you remember what you are testing with this run. Enter the anomalously scattering atom. Let's use SE for selenium and set the wavelength to the peak at 0.9792 angstroms. Let's assume, as a rather typical case, that we have 12 sites, a high resolution limit of 2 angstroms, a solvent fraction of about 0.5, and 500 residues. You could enter a sequence file if you wanted to instead of specifying the number of residues. Now, a key parameter in planned SAT experiment is the target anomalous signal. The GUI is going to try and achieve the target anomalous signal you specify by adjusting the I over sigma of the data to be collected. If you specify a high anomalous signal, it will require more accurate data than a low one. We're ready to go. Hit run, and after a few moments, you will get this result panel. It summarizes the information you typed in, along with the characteristics of the anomalous scatterer, SE in this case. Notice the F double prime value of 3.84, which is quite high. The summary then lists, as a function of the high resolution limit, the number of reflections, the I over sigma chosen by the GUI, the resulting half dataset correlation and estimated anomalous correlation, the anomalous signal obtained, the probability that we will solve the structure with this data, and the expected figure of merit or quality of your SAD phased map. In this case, a value of 20 for I over sigma is required to obtain a half dataset correlation of 0.32 and the target anomalous signal of 15. The probability of solving the structure with this data would be about 83%, and the expected figure of merit would be 0.31. This is using all data to a resolution of 3 angstroms. Now let's see what would happen if everything were the same, except we only had sulfur as the anomalous scatterer, and we collected the data at a wavelength of 1.8 angstroms. In this case, the F double prime is only 0.74, much less than the 3.84 we found for selenium. Now we find it takes an I over sigma of 98 to get a half data set CC of 0.29 and an anomalous signal of 15. Compare this with a required I over sigma of just 20 for the selenium experiment. The probability of solving the structure with this data is still 83%, and the expected figure of merit of phasing is 0.3. If you want to test out more possibilities, try changing the target anomalous signal, and you can see what I over sigma would be required to get each value you choose. Good luck with using planned SAT experiment in your work. If you have questions or feedback, you are welcome to contact us at help@phoenixonline.org or tutorials@phoenixonline.org.